In the wake of the tragedy at Sandy Hook Elementary School in Connecticut, many in the community have been coming together, and they are relying on their faith to get through some really dark days. We want to talk about the role of faith. Bishop Robert Wright of the Episcopal Diocese of Atlanta, and you have an amazing, unique background. You were born Roman Catholic, yes. An orphan. Yeah. You went to Howard University. You majored in political science and history. Yeah. You were in the Navy, search and rescue. You are now a bishop. Yeah. You have this wonderful, broad life experience. There are people who look at this tragedy and they ask and they wonder, how does something like this happen? How do you have faith? How does God figure into any of this?
Sure. You know, I mean, the first thing we say, of course, is that our hearts and prayers are with those who are in the midst of this tragic season. And we can't begin to put all the words that are necessary around this. We just simply let people know that, as the president said, you're not alone in this. And we want you to know that, you know, our prayers and goodwill are flooding into you in intangible, intangible ways. But at the same time, real faith accounts for human tragedy and human loss and grief. I mean, a real God can help us in a real world. And I think that in some of the ways we've heard the conversation framed, it doesn't really adequately get to that. We believe, and at least in the Christian tradition, that that God finds us amidst brutality and violence, and is that resource in the midst of that. So the fact that tragedy has visited us is not evidence of the absence of God. In fact, I think, and I'm sure we'll see as the days unfold, that there'll be these wonderful expressions of grace in the midst of this tragedy in Newtown, Connecticut, and all over the country. And already people from a lot of different backgrounds and faith traditions are coming together and supporting one another, and that's the best of faith.
How do you approach people who think that this is a time that has tested their faith and challenged their faith, and maybe they are losing faith because they feel such an overwhelming sense of grief?
Sure. I would say to them, I would listen to them, and I think that those feelings are legitimate. But I would guide them, and I would help them to understand that the best part of our tradition enlarges and deepens our faith in the very midst of these sorts of occurrences. We talk about the cross in Christianity. The cross helps us to understand that God is with us amidst sorrow. And I think that as we go deeper in our faith, we will find grace in the midst of this.
Bishop, I want to play this clip for you. This is of George Hochspring. This is the husband of Dawn Hochspring, who was the principal at the school.
Sure.
Who was killed.
Sure.
Well, I'm not angry anymore. I'm not angry. I'm not angry anymore. I'm not angry. I'm just very sad.
He's not angry. He's not angry anymore. He's just very, very sad.
Sure.
Where does the role of forgiveness play in this? How important is that? Is that something that is going to take a really long time?
Yes. This is the gift that faith gives us. It allows us to process complicated emotions like hurt, and it allows us and guides us towards forgiveness. We don't forgive others for them. We forgive, we use our forgiveness so that we might be set free. God shows us God's grace towards us, and we play that back in our lives and in our lives with others. And so we will need to forgive, but it is a process, and it takes time, and it's about prayer, and it's about the study of God's goodness towards us, even though we've, you know, in the midst of our own absence of grace towards others, we find that we've been forgiven, and so we mirror that back in the world. And so this is a process, and I would say that one of the things that we've got to do is we've got to forgive Adam Lanza. We've got to find it within our hearts to forgive him. He was a broken young man from what we can tell right now, and we've got to find it within the best of our faith tradition to forgive him and to move forward.
I want to ask you too, for those who don't share in the faith tradition,
sure.
Maybe they don't believe in heaven. They don't believe there's a better place for a six-year-old to be,
right.
Except for in their arms.
Right.
Well, what do you say to those folks who don't necessarily believe in God or have that kind of faith?
Well, I think that we can go so far in just in our capacity to love and to be with one another. We can go so far, but I think that when we get into processing complex emotions like the need for forgiveness, I think we lack the strength to take us the full way in and of ourselves, the best of ourselves. And so I think this is where faith is a real resource to us. It moves us beyond ourselves. It enlarges our hearts. It stirs up reservoirs of compassion in us. And that's what I would say. I said we need to draw down on that.
All right. right. Bishop Wright, thank you so much for your words and your encouragement. A lot of people listening, a lot of people really need that at this time.
Thank you so much.
All right, we're going to take a quick break and we'll have more.
Okay.